I just could see how excited you got. You can just try replicating a model here. So that is one reason I believe most of the people here are very reluctant to share their secrets online or things like that. Because they feel they have struck some gold or something by identifying a product and they can keep selling it for life. So that is suitable if you have a lot of money to spend and you can invest in advertisement budgets and things like that. That gives you quick returns. So they're willing to sacrifice a product to stay true to their cause. But here in India, when you're starting off as a small brand, the whole brand rides on your shoulders and it should be true from your story. Yes, I can understand. See, certain things you can and you can't.
You can't, yes.
Yes.
And I wanted to share about the personal experience that I was talking about, like about the soap journey and things like that. I did share a part of it. One part is I went to, I traveled for work abroad. So I visited showroom. Of course, Body Shop and all, when I used to visit, I'm like, okay, nice, okay, brand. And when you enter that, you know, the fragrance and the aroma, the feeling, the factor of like feeling pampered is great, but I could never, you know, okay, fine, whatever, it's a, you know, another cosmetic thing. But I walked into showroom and it was like for a kid, how you though I'm a person who will not change my soaps and things like that, for me it was like a galaxy opened for have you visited
Lakshmi? No, I haven't.
Okay, so that was a place where for me soaps and anything related to bath products interested me a lot. So this is what was like a you know, kid in a Disneyland kind of a feeling. It was amazing. So that's when like bath products can be as interesting as like their aisle just goes on, like from skincare to bath, and just bath products itself is like so many sections, I would say. So that was another personal experience along with like whatever I shared not many products I used to use and then switched to Khadi. And then like,
see, this can be your story.
Okay.
See, seeing you, I just could see how excited you got. So, you know, you can just try replicating a model here, which is a good point to start off. Or you can try it online. Set up a small room. You know, when the customers come in, they don't order from the website. They come on a video call and you show them the products and they order. So there should be something unique and something different which they obtain. And it should be true to you. So that is the only thing which is one of the most important here.
Just make a note.
My total belief is that the product matters only about 20%. All the other 80% is the USP that matters.
And I always keep seeing you in telling you in the video that soap making is just one part of it. 90% is marketing. And that, who else can be a better testimony for that? Like, I know to make products, but I'm not able to sell it.
So it's the first thing is you need to decide on your USP, and this should be true to your belief
so system.
Only then will it stay unique. Otherwise it's just like, you know, you're copying something from someone else, and someone else will come and you know, can take it away from you easily. So that is one reason I believe most of the people here are very reluctant to share their secrets online or things like that. Because they feel they have struck some gold or something by identifying a product and they can keep selling it for life. It doesn't happen that way. You need to change, you need to move. So you need to have your goals or your problem, what you're solving, set, and change whatever you're doing to satisfy it.
So you said either you I can sell it by ingredients or the what do you call problem solving, or experience based,
correct. So it should be, it should, you know, either satisfy the person in a financial point of view. So one, your product should be cheaper than the rest compared to all the other things. So for this you can take Jio's example.
Jio's
example. So that is one good example. And so that is, tomorrow if someone else comes and offers something cheaper and better than Jio, it goes off.
It goes off, correct.
So that is suitable if you have a lot of money to spend and you can invest in advertisement budgets and things like that. That gives you quick returns.
Right.
You put something in, it comes back very quick.
Correct.
So the other way to do is, you differentiate it based on the ingredients. Say, for this matter,
yeah,
they stick with organic.
Okay.
So if something is not organic and something is not natural, they don't make the product at all.
Okay.
They don't have creams.
Right. Okay.
So they're willing to sacrifice a product to stay true to their cause.
Cost. Okay.
So they don't do anything which is not organic. They don't do with anything which is not plant-based or which is not natural.
Okay.
Even if it is skipping a product altogether.
Okay. Sure.
So yes, creams market is a very big market.
Yeah.
With their brand size, they can easily capitalize on it.
Mm-hmm.
But they choose not to.
Not to.
So their concept is organic and how they source their products and all that. That is their USP and they stick to it.
Okay.
That is one type, mm-hmm. So, you know, setting up with how products are sourced and what you use in your product.
Correct.
And all that.
Mm-hmm.
The next thing is how you package it.
Mm.
So it's either ethically sourced or you don't use plastic.
Mm-hmm.
Or
mm-hmm.
You take back your bottles,
mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Whatever it may be.
Mm-hmm.
So I think some foreign brand does that. They collect back their bottles. Even though they use plastic, they collect back the bottles.
Okay, okay.
So they're environmentally friendly and they reuse it or recycle it, but okay. They, you know, collect back the plastic bottles and all that.
Okay, okay, sure.
So this is one USP.
Mm-hmm.
This, I think, resonates with all these foreign brands and people are more moving towards these kind of behaviors on total.
Correct.
But here in India, when you're starting off as a small brand.
Yes.
The whole brand rides on your shoulders and it should be true from your story.
Okay.
So, take your time. It's not like you need to set something up today or tomorrow.
Right.
Up to that, copy something from whatever's happening.
Sure.
Just keep it going.
Sure.
Try different methods.
Sure.
But at some point of time, you will surely feel this is something which really rings true to me. And then when you talk about that product, the way you speak about it will totally differ.
Okay.
So say for example, you were telling me about the experience, right? In
yes.
Yeah. So in that case, I will not be talking about what ingredients I've used.
Mm-hmm.
I will not be talking about anything of that.
Mm.
I'll say you can come to our place, you can cut your own soaps, you can wash it, you can try it.
Right.
You can feel the product before you use.
Mm-hmm.
So that is what you'll be talking about more.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Sure.
So what do I do?
But that requires like more like a setup and you
yes
know,
yes yeah, I can understand see yeah, yeah. Certain things you can and you can't
yes.
So say today I don't have that budget.
Yes.
You can even start it off small with a video call or you go live on Facebook or YouTube, display your products. This product is you've seen those North Indian videos where they auction earrings and all that?
No, I haven't.
So normally what happens is some new concept, it generally gets invented abroad, then it is adopted by the North Indians, then it trickles down to us.
Yes.
So I have seen these North Indian people, they have these earrings which they sell, there's one big chart, and there are numbers put on it, all these different earrings are placed in one number,
okay.
And they go live
okay.
on Facebook, and people comment their prices.
Oh.
They say item number. There'll be a number stuck to it and they say, this is this price and one person, they auction it. So each person quotes a price and the highest bidder, they strike out the product and they ship it to them.
Okay.
You can do that.
It's a new concept, but how do we execute is something we have to figure out.
Yeah, you can do it online. You can just say camera, set it up on tripod or a mobile phone, put it up on a tripod. And you just start talking.
Okay.
So I've made these products.
Uh-huh.
This is there.
Mm-hmm.
Cut it. You can see how it lathers.
Mm.
This is there. This is there. This is this.
Mm.
Start selling.
Okay. Sure.
That is one. Mm. Or you can try pop shops.
Those stalls you mean?
Yeah. Uh-huh. Small stalls.
Okay. Okay.
In posh areas.
Okay.
Provided if Lush Beauty is the concept.
Okay.
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 I'm just explaining
sure,
things
sure,
to that.
Sure.
So you can set up small shops.
Okay.
Small pop shops. Set it up with a small water tank or something like that.
Uh-huh.
So where people can come wash and try and go.
Sure, sure.
Ask them to post a selfie or something.
Sure.
Say you post a selfie with the stall, I'll give you one free soap or something like that.
Yeah.
So the organic reach is very high and your concept is unique and it gets heard a lot and a lot of people come to know about it.
Sure.
And you talk about only that. You say why it is better.
Yeah.
So normally, you know what happens, you buy a soap based on the ingredients, it doesn't lather the way you want to.
Yeah.
Smell doesn't come out the way you want to.
Right.
So smell, you can't do it online.
Right.
But, you know, the feel of it, the texture, you can yeah. explain it to them. You can yeah. say it is soft, it is smooth, see how it is.
It's more
know.
On articulation
correct.
Skills. Okay.
Correct.
Okay.
And then you pack it live in front of them, and you can give it.
Okay.
So that is one way.